Just when you thought the drama between Johnny Depp and Amber Heard took a bit of a break, Depp found himself making headlines yet again. Unfortunately, the headlines have not been in his favor. After Depp lost the libel case against British tabloid The Sun, we thought it would be interesting to take a look at the celebrities that have backed Depp during his ongoing legal battle with ex-wife Amber Heard. Given Depp's recent loss, we wondered if any of these celebrities might regret backing him and are now planning on bowing out. What does this all mean for Johnny Depp's future, and could this be the infamous end to his career? Before we dive a bit deeper, make sure to subscribe to our channel to keep up with the latest celebrity news.
Good morning, Starshine. The Earth says hello.
And before we get started, let's catch you up, just in case you've missed all the drama surrounding the two former lovebirds. Johnny Depp and Amber Heard first met on the set of the film The Rum Diary in 2009 and started dating in 2012. The couple were married in 2015, but Heard filed for both a divorce and a restraining order a year later. Since then, the exes have been locked in a contentious legal battle, with Depp filing a $50 million defamation lawsuit against Heard. Heard made allegations that Depp had physically and verbally abused her while under the influence of drugs and alcohol. Depp, however, denied all allegations, saying that, in reality, Heard had abused him. Things turned in Johnny's favor when an audio recording was leaked, revealing Amber's abusive nature towards Johnny. This led to Johnny receiving backing from more and more people as they hashtagged Justice for Johnny, but things turned for the worse when Johnny decided to sue The Sun newspaper. On the 2nd of November 2020, Johnny Depp lost his libel lawsuit against British newspaper The Sun for branding him a wife-beater with reference to his relationship with Amber Heard. Unfortunately, the case did not go as Johnny planned, as it tragically laid bare his chaotic lifestyle, including his ongoing struggle with drugs and alcohol. The verdict came as a shock to many, especially after the leaked voice recording between Amber and Johnny. Legal experts consider Depp had no choice but to sue The Sun, as, in the current era, accusations of domestic violence would do more damage to his career than details of a substance abuse. We wondered if the handful of celebrities who publicly backed Johnny prior to the case are now regretting their decision after Johnny's unfortunate loss. Either way, we thought it would be interesting to have a look at which celebrities backed Johnny in the last couple of years. Johnny has had his fair share of intense long-term relationships during his time in Hollywood, so it came as no surprise when Vanessa Paradis and Winona Ryder voiced their support for their former partner. Paradis, with whom Johnny shares two beautiful children, was brave enough to defend her ex-partner, even though at the time she received a lot of hate for going against a fellow woman. Then there's Winona Ryder, who famously dated Johnny for 4 years. Despite their public and somewhat messy relationship, Winona remains very fond of the 57-year-old. However, it seemed both ex-partners were careful when giving their witness statements, which is understandable given the Me Too movement that has risen the past few years. Both Paradis and Ryder acknowledge that they don't want to call anyone a liar and do not know what happened between the couple behind closed doors. Nevertheless, both women made a point to defend Johnny by saying that the picture Amber was painting of him was incredibly untrue, judging from their frame of reference. They went on to say that regardless of what Amber had said, it is nothing like the Johnny they know and love. The Johnny they know and love would never be violent or abusive towards anyone. Vanessa's sister, Allison Paradis, also sided with her sister's former partner. She showed her support on Instagram by posting a photo of the two with the caption, "You are and always will be family to me." Now, we don't know about you, but it's not every day you see your in-laws defend you, much less your ex-in-laws. So the fact that she went out of her way to defend Depp is pretty huge. And of course, there was no surprise that Depp's daughter Lily was also one of the first to defend her dad's honor. She posted a photo from an article where the LAPD came to Amber and Johnny's house after a call of domestic violence from Amber. The call was later dismissed as there was no evidence of any crime. She then posted a since-deleted photo with her and her dad when she was just a baby, captioning it, "My dad is the sweetest, most loving person I know. He's been nothing but a wonderful father to my little brother and I, and everyone who knows him would say the same." We can only imagine how much the support meant for Johnny, knowing his own daughter did not believe the claims and stood behind her father during the hardest time of his life. We can't help but wonder why Lily has since taken down the photo. In addition to family members, other celebrities also voiced their public support for Johnny. One of the most unexpected celebrities to back Johnny was singer-songwriter Sia. Sia's impromptu support seemed very unexpected, but that did not stop her from siding with the actor. The singer came out on Twitter to address her support for Depp. She tweeted, "Just showing my public support for Johnny Depp. I mean, I'd love him to get clean and stop with the jewelry, but he is clearly the victim after hearing those tapes." The singer went even further by calling out Amber's ex-boyfriend Elon Musk for allegedly protecting Amber and not getting her the help she needs. Although no one is sure where this sudden burst of support came from, it's very clear that Sia was strongly opinionated and at that point wanted to see Amber get the justice Sia thought she deserved. Next, we have Paul Bettany. Paul is an actor that has worked alongside Johnny in the past. Johnny must have left quite an impression on Bettany. Based on the three times that they have worked together, Bettany figured he was as good a person as any to be a character witness for Depp. He posted a supportive tweet saying, "Known Johnny Depp for years and through several relationships, he is the sweetest, kindest, gentlest man I've ever known, just saying." Although, having Bettany on his side didn't exactly help Depp, as texts between the two actors were revealed in court. During their exchange, it seemed as if Depp was blowing off steam, but at the same time saying things like, "Let's drown her before we burn her." Not the kind of evidence Depp needed at the time. Spectators wondered if Depp ever regretted getting support from Bettany, as these text messages obviously did not go down well for Depp. Then there was the longtime friend and stand-up comedian whose work ranges from true-life graphic perversion to volatile social criticism, Doug Stanhope. When asked about Amber and Johnny's relationship, Stanhope said how he and his friends would watch the toxicity between Amber and Johnny build since before they were even married. He claims to have watched Amber manipulate Johnny when Johnny was at his weakest. Stanhope further mentioned how he couldn't name one person closely associated with Johnny that didn't feel the same as he did. Doug said that Johnny was in a dour mood the night before the alleged assault. At first, they thought it was because of his mother's death the day before, but Depp opened up in the most vulnerable of ways and said it was not only his mother, but that Amber was going to leave him. He said that she was threatening to lie about him publicly in any and every possible duplicitous way if he didn't agree to her terms. It was then that Stanhope allegedly told Johnny how he and his girlfriend Bingo must have been well aware of how manipulative Amber was to Johnny this whole time. Then, there's the confusing statement of an interior decorator, Laura Debonair. Although she is not a celeb herself, she is involved enough in Hollywood to have played a role in the trial. Laura gave written testimony in favor of Depp, claiming that she didn't see Amber's bruises after an alleged fight between her and Depp. The question that came up was if this statement was true or if she was forced to sign it. Confusion sprung when Amber brought out a recording of a conversation she had with Laura after she had signed the statement. In the recording, Laura talks about how Depp's attorney was the biggest asshole under the sun. She testified via video that the attorney wrote the majority of the statement and that she signed it because she was put under pressure. However, Depp's defense fought back by presenting a follow-up email, which Laura wrote after the recording. In the mail, Laura again confirmed that she did not see bruises on Heard, nor witnessed any violence on his behalf. Although in court it was proved that she was not coerced into anything and completed and signed her final statement, we are still not sure whose side she is actually on or if Amber had anything to do with this. Looking back at the lawsuit, spectators can't help but notice that Depp isn't just the loser here legally, he has also clearly lost the plot. The whole goal of his libel lawsuit was to rehabilitate his reputation, and certainly, if Depp is telling the truth, one can understand why he would want to clear his name. But by filing multiple lawsuits, it seems that Depp is only prolonging and expanding the coverage.
Well, you find yourself in a panicked situation, you know, flustered, whatever, you know.
Now, what does this all mean for Johnny's career? Will Dior drop him as the face of the brand? How many of his current and future projects fall under wraps? Prior to Depp's case, director David Yates and author J.K. Rowling made the executive decision to keep Depp in the Fantastic Beasts franchise. At the time, many wondered how J.K. Rowling could be happy with having Depp on board, being a survivor of domestic violence herself. Before the libel ruling, Yates came out with a statement that he went to Entertainment Weekly saying Amber is one person who took a pop out of Depp and claimed whatever accusations are out there. Those accusations did not tally with the person that he has been working with the past few years. Unfortunately for Depp, a few days after the libel case, Warner Brothers made the executive decision to let him go from the Fantastic Beasts franchise. Is this the first of many? There is no doubt that Johnny is going to have to clean up his act, but is Depp's reservoir of talent good enough to resurrect his career and reputation in Hollywood? We all know that Hollywood loves a good comeback story, but given the Me Too movement era, it's very hard to have a comeback when you have domestic and sexual violence behind your name. Has Johnny Depp's quest in trying to rehabilitate his reputation just led to its tarnation? Only time will tell.